going to talk about today. Equities are your partner in inflation. All other asset classes, particularly fixed income, will be hurt by inflation, but equities will benefit. Say if you have 100 rupees today and a piece of cake is there which is cost 100 rupees, you can take that 100 rupees, buy that cake and eat it. But instead of that, like Ajay mentioned, we are a big country of savers. What we do, we put the money in a bank. Say today you put the money in a bank at say around 8% rate of interest. After 1 year, you will get 8 rupees interest. On that you have to pay tax, whatever your tax rate is. Say you pay 2 rupees tax, you get 8 minus 2, 6 rupees. So your 100 becomes 106. But now, because of this inflation, your cake which was today 100 rupees will next year maybe become 110 rupees. You cannot buy the cake because you have 106 while the cake now costs 110. So you have lost because of inflation. So you have to invest in something which is in partner inflation. Equity is a partner in inflation. Instead of putting in bank, example, say that cake company was a listed company, you invest in that equity would have appreciated normally by 10% because the earnings would grow by 10% only because of inflation. And buy stocks of companies which you cannot live without. Buy companies with good managements, hold stocks for the long term, buy stocks with high conviction. Don't put all your eggs in one basket. For a common investor, it's very true. But a lot of the big investors have really made money by putting eggs in concentrated baskets because they understand that. If you don't understand, you buy what NSE says, buy an NSE Nifty ETF. It is one of the best ways to invest for a common investor. You don't have to have any knowledge about any stock, any industry, any company, any management. You just buy that, you invest in the best 50 companies in India. Stock prices are slaves to earnings, but stock valuations are not. In the short term, the valuations may fluctuate like a pendulum, right to left, from overvaluation, undervaluation. But if you own stock for 5 to 10 years plus, for at least 2 cycles, over very long term, 10 year plus, you will always get the earnings growth in the company. But if you try to time the market, sometimes you may be successful, sometimes you may not be successful. And if you are not successful, the point is not about losing money. The point is about losing confidence. And the next time you will never come back to the market. So therefore I tell people, particularly young investors, that please think about long term. Even because if you lose little money at a young age is not important. You can again earn the money by working. But if you lose confidence and don't participate for next 25 years, that would be the worst case for you. So therefore it's very important to participate for the long term. See, in the market many times we look at cheap prices and penny stocks and cheap stocks. But we should understand that price has no meaning. What we are buying is, we are not buying that price, we are not buying 5-10 rupees stocks. We are buying the company behind the stock, the asset behind the stock, the business behind the stock, the promoter, his vision behind the stock. If that all doesn't match, the price of the stock has no meaning. So please don't look at cheap prices, cheap stocks. Look at what valuation you are getting, for what price you are paying, instead in that price, what kind of earnings you are getting, what kind of assets you are getting, what kind of future vision you are getting from the promoter. In the equity markets, there are two kinds of investors. One who don't know where the market is going, and one who don't know that they don't know where the market is going. One who don't know where the market is going, and the other one who doesn't know where the market is going, but he doesn't know that he doesn't know where the market is going. And there is also a third category of people who don't know where the market is going, but they behave as if they know where the market is going because their profession depends on that. So in short, nobody knows where the market is going. We only know one thing, that India is a growth country. India is growing at a very good rate. Indian companies are doing good. Entrepreneurs are doing good. Managements are doing good. And we have to just participate in this growth over next 5, 10, 15, 20 years. These are some common equity mistakes which we make, like price will come back. There are many stocks, you know, which have fallen over the last few years. I will not name anything, but which were like 1,000 rupees, 500 rupees, 200 rupees. Today they are 5 and 10 rupees. So just because the price has fallen doesn't mean it will recover back. You have to not look at the price. You have to look at the business behind the price, the company, the asset, the earnings behind the price. In market, we have to be very humble. If we are not humble, market will teach us in a very bad manner. So be humble. If we have done a mistake, okay, no problem. Everybody does mistake. Just accept the mistake, get out, and then start fresh. Equity will never give linear return. The graph over the long term will be upward sloping, but it will never be straight. It will be like a curve, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. So don't try to time that. But over 5 to 10 years, it will always be upward sloping. But if you say over next 1, 2, 3 months, 6 months, I don't know what will happen. Mutual fund is another method of investing. I think most of us know. It collects money from different different investors, and then it invests in whatever the schemes are, whether it's equity scheme, debt scheme, liquid scheme, etc. See, remember, good stocks produce cash flows during good time and bad times with tax breaks. Investments give us a lot of tax advantage also. The tax, the capital gain tax is much lower than the normal marginal rate of tax. Even dividends up to a certain point is exempt. For individuals also up to 10 lakhs is exempt. And remember, recession is too important an event. Don't let it pass by. During recession, during bad times, you will get to a chance to buy good companies at the best rate. Like 2008 was a great example. During that time, so many good companies were available at such good prices, which never came after that and may never come also. Lot of the good companies, you will not, even if you see just now, the Nifty is almost at close to within 5% of the all-time high or whatever it is. But lot of mid-caps are like 20-30% high, lower than the last year highs. So there are a lot of opportunities over there. At the same time, in a lot of the good large cap companies, there are not much opportunities because they have not corrected. They will not fall that way. Unless the overall world and the economy becomes very bad, those companies will not correct so easily. Thank you very much.
Moving ahead, an interactive session between Tata Investments' Mehrab Irani and ET Now's Ajay Sharma ensured that the crucial audience queries were addressed.
Let's talk about asset allocation. Can you explain what is asset allocation?
See, when you are young, you have a lot of time on your side. So at that time, you have to understand the difference between risk and volatility. Risk is losing capital and, more important, losing the purchasing power of your capital, purchasing power of your money to inflation. While volatility is just up and down movement. If you are young, if you have time on your side, as I said, if you are a 25-year-old person, you have still 25-30 years plus to work. At that time, you are not worried about what will happen tomorrow or what will happen after 1 year. Because you are not dependent on your investment income. You are building your investment edge. You are building your asset, doing your asset allocation. At that time, you have to concentrate on building your nest egg for next 10, 20, 30 years. And everybody has different goals. See, generally there are three types of goals. Short-term goals, medium-term goals, long-term goals. Asset allocation, which we have to do, is as per our goals. So when you are doing your longer-term goals, which are like 10, 15, 20 year plus, majority of that has to be in something on a growth asset, which will grow. Which will grow with inflation, which will beat inflation. And equities are number one at beating inflation. So for your long-term goals, majority of your money, maybe 80% plus, has to be in equities. For your medium-term goals, at least 60-70% has to be in equities. And for your short-term goals, which is like a one-year goal, for that, majority has to be in something like a debt fund or fixed deposit or something like that. Because there, volatility becomes important.
Let's spend some time on compounding. Can you help us understand?
Compounding is most important, and it is actually called the eighth wonder of the world. A 5 year difference, say 10,000 rupees were invested at 12% per annum, which is very easy to get. In fact, Nifty over longer terms have given 14-15% per annum compounding. So if you can manage 12% compounding after tax, which is not difficult, in 25 years you will accumulate 1.8 crores. But just 5 years more and you will accumulate double of that, almost 3.5 crores. So that is the power of compounding. 5 years extra and you double your money. So every 5 years you will keep doubling your money. That is the power of compounding. Because in compounding you get interest on interest. You get earnings on earnings. For compounding you have to stay in the asset. The problem what happens is that ek thoda market mein thoda utar chadhav aa gaya, thoda girav aa gaya, little problem and we are out of it. Okay, the market may fall also 5%, no doubt. You will be very happy. Arey, maine bech diya, dekho 100 ka 95 ho gaya. But what happens that after that 95 suddenly again becomes 100 and 100 becomes 120. And then you miss the whole thing. And then you will never buy it. 120 will think, arey, kabhi 100 aayega to lega. So you miss the compounding thing. So compounding happens only when you stay in the asset class. In fact, it falls, you buy more. That way you will multiply your compounding power. And over longer terms, believe me, that will be the biggest difference which will happen to your asset. Nothing else will be more important.
Mehrab, let's come to the other important point, which a lot of retail investors get shaken out of the market. Bazaar mein utar chadhav aata hai. So how can investors stick to the investment?
Yeah, Ajay, I think you made a very relevant point. I think that's why the psychology of investments comes very important. See, we may have all the knowledge. You may have all the economic knowledge, fundamental knowledge, technical knowledge. But unless our mental framework is not suited to it, it's very difficult to become successful in any field, or and more so in investments, because investment is a group activity, it's not an individual activity. You may invest individually, but the outcome of the results happens because of group action. In the markets, there are millions and millions of people participating, and everybody's thought process is different. As I said, everybody would be intelligent on their own. Like today, say we are 100 people plus over here, each of one of us I am sure is very intelligent, but when collectively we come together and we have to make some decisions, most of the time that decision may be little substandard compared to individual decision making, and that is explored in the market, and market has its own methods of removing human weaknesses. So we have to understand the difference between risk and volatility. Utar charao aata rahega, that is volatility. It is like our heart, wo ECG upar niche jata hai, jab tak ECG upar niche jata hai, we are alive. Ek bar seedha ho gaya, we are dead. So same way market also will keep going up down, market is alive. Because different players have different activities. You realize one thing, at any point of time, somebody is buying the same share and somebody is selling the same share at the same price, at the same time. And both of them believe that they are right. At the same time, same price, say 100 rupees, same share, say stock A, same two people are buying, one is selling, there are two individuals. Both of them think they are right. So market has its own mind. So we have to depend on our own mind, our own thinking process. Don't see what others are doing. Don't see what the top investors are doing, the top businessmen are doing. You are not concerned with them. Their objective may be different. Many times people blindly follow, ke usne le liya toh main bhi le lega. That is the worst method of investing. His objective may be different. His time frame may be different. His leveraging may be different. So you see what you are best at. And the most important thing is to stick in. Let the price go up, let the price go down. And if you can't do it, then SIP is a very good method. Because SIP may individual decision making goes. It's automatic. Just give your bank instruction. Automatic every month some X amount is invested. And don't interfere with it.
Okay, so let's have some questions. 2-3 saal se main stock mein invest kar raha hu. Jaisa ki har ek sector ke do stock aisa lena. 2-3 saal se le raha hu. Lekin kya hua hai, kaafi wo portfolio niche hi bata raha hai. तो मुझे ये कहना है कि अभी ये समझो 25-30 लाख मेरे पास है तो मैं ये लिक्विड फंड में या उसमें जाऊं या पोर्टफोलियो में शेयर मार्केट में इन्वेस्ट करूं कौन सा बेटर रहेगा.
यू नो अगर कुछ प्रॉब्लम हुआ मेडिकल तो वी गो टू अ डॉक्टर, कुछ लीगल प्रॉब्लम हुआ तो लॉयर के पास जाते. तो सेम वे व्हेन फाइनेंशियल इन्वेस्टमेंट्स है सो वी हैव टू गो टू अ फाइनेंशियल प्लानर, फाइनेंशियल एडवाइजर, ब्रोकर, समबडी वो जो आपको प्रॉपर एडवाइस देगा. सो आपने जो भी स्टॉक लिया है, अपना खुद का रिसर्च किया है, किसी के एडवाइस पे लिए मुझे नहीं मालूम, बट अगर वो अच्छे कंपनीज है और अभी भी अच्छे परफॉर्म कर रहे हैं तो नो डाउट उसका बिकॉज ऑफ मार्केट उतार चढ़ाव जो होता है प्राइस गिरा होगा. बट ओवर लॉन्गर टर्म इफ दे आर गुड कंपनीज, गुड रिसर्च एंड यू नो अबाउट दैट कंपनीज एंड यू आर कॉन्फिडेंट, तो लॉन्ग टर्म में वो उसका प्राइस जरूर बढ़ेगा. उसका अर्निंग्स ग्रो हो रहा है, मैनेजमेंट अच्छा है, बिजनेस तो वो बढ़ेगा, तो इनफैक्ट आपको ज्यादा लेना चाहिए. बट अगर वो कंपनीज अच्छे नहीं है, मुझे नहीं मालूम जो भी कंपनीज है, सो देन अगर वो ओरिजिनल डिसीजन ही रॉन्ग था तो देन टाइम हैज कम कि आपको डिसीजन करेक्ट करना चाहिए. और मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्या है कि हम लोग इन्वेस्टमेंट को डिफिकल्ट बनाते हैं. हम लोग जाके 10 जन के पास से एडवाइस मांगते हैं. और अगर जैसे वापस अगर आपको कुछ मेडिकल प्रॉब्लम है तो आप डॉक्टर के पास से ही जाके एडवाइस मांगोगे, राह चढ़ते किसी के पास एडवाइस नहीं मांगोगे. बट एज फार एज इन्वेस्टमेंट इज कंसर्न, हम लोग किसी के पास भी एडवाइस मांगने जाते हैं और कोई भी आके एडवाइस देके जाता है. कोई भी आके अभी हम लोग बैठे इधर चार जन आएगा, अरे बॉस आई बॉट दिस स्टॉक, एक महीने में डबल हो गया, ये ट्रिपल, एंड देन यू फील अरे मैंने मिस कर दिया, उसने कमा लिया. यू नो दैट फियर एंड दैट ग्रीड इज देयर ऑफ मिसिंग, उसके लिए हम लोग बहुत बार गलत डिसीजन ले लेते हैं. सो इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड, अगर आप किसी को भी अगर स्टॉक मार्केट का ज्यादा नॉलेज नहीं है, बट एवरीबडी हैज राइट टू पार्टिसिपेट. Don't understand to do, and if you're not inclined to do, then just invest in very simple, just invest in the index. The index will give you average return. The index, say the Nifty index, it is made of 50 best companies in India. और जो NSE है वो खुद ऊपर नीचे करता रहता है. अगर कोई कंपनी अच्छा नहीं परफॉर्म कर रहा है वो खुद निकाल देता है और कुछ नया कंपनी नया सेक्टर्स को डालता है जो अच्छा परफॉर्म कर रहा है, तो वही आपका काम कर रहा है. आपको कुछ करने का जरूरत नहीं है.
थैंक यू सो मच.